This is a photo of the Macefield House, taken in 2014. The house is a regional famous attraction in Seattle, but if you're like me, you immediately find the entire photo evocative. There's something gleeful and rebellious about the picture. A lone farmhouse suffocated by modern office buildings. How contemporary. How romantic. How punk. The house was owned by Edith Macefield. She famously refused to sell it for $1 million in 2006, when developers were proselytizing homeowners with the spiritual power of cash and the conviction that their land was needed for a commercial, competitive downtown. After I saw this photo, I wanted to learn more about Edith. Mrs. Macefield was born in Portland and raised by a single mother. As a child, she was unusually clever, learning both French and German in primary school. And at 16, she confidently informed her mother she was going to college, but secretly joined the US Army instead. In fact, during World War II, she was sent to fight in England. This worked until officers discovered she had, in fact, exaggerated her age and ejected her. But despite her removal from the army, she chose to remain in England. Instead of returning home, she got a house and took in war orphans. Later still, she would surreptitiously tour across Europe with the Royal Army's marching band, convincing some of her friends that she was now working as a British spy. Eventually, she did return to America, however, and settled in Ballard, Seattle, where this photo is taken. At that time, Ballard was a rural neighborhood by the lake. But by her 80s, Ballard, Seattle was no longer rural, and her neighbors had long since either moved to the afterlife or the suburbs. And across the street, the developers were continuing their outrageous success in their block consolidation scheme. Eventually, they got all of 46th Street except for Mrs. Macefield's house, which stood defiant in what must have seemed like, to the developers, a small, private, pagan, goat-worshipping shrine next to the Sistine Chapel. If you're wondering about the house itself, it isn't very big. The home is only 1,000 square feet, and the land less than half an acre, barely enough yard to include a paved driveway or lay out a spooky display for Halloween. By all accounts, Mrs. Macefield had little to lose and a lot to gain, namely $1 million. $1 million for grandmother's dumpy farmhouse, I think? If so, that means my net worth would increase by $1 million. Happy to do business with you, the worst half of my mind is already rehearsing. But Edith is not like me. She politely told the developers no in 2006 and shut the door on them like common Jehovah's Witnesses. And so eventually, the money men were forced to design their new gyms and shoe stores around Mrs. Macefield's house, and in the process, creating a symbol of quiet, indomitable integrity. One developer actually said about Edith in the paper, "Honestly, I think we're a lot alike. I'm stubborn and so is she. We had some incredible arguments. She was amazingly smart." I think this illustration of Edith's character is probably true. No fool gets to live the life she lived without being amazingly smart. Anyway, Edith died in 2012 without ever selling the damn house. So the home still stands there, like an old fern beneath the jungle of concrete. But honestly, I think perhaps this photo is the best epitaph Mrs. Macefield could have been given. For it shows a woman who lived life her way, always, even when that world so often tried to push her down.